Assalamualaikum, wonderful people. Today we will discuss about the monocot root and anatomy of monocot root cross section. There are always flowers for those who want to see them by Henri Matisse. Today's learning objectives are anatomy of monocot root, include epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, vascular tissues, conjunctive tissues, and pith. Anatomically, monocot root has the following parts: epidermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, vascular tissues, conjunctive tissues, and pith. All the parts that are mentioned above are now elaborated with colored markers. Anatomy of monocot root. Epidermis, first part, also known as epiblema, piliferous layer, and rhizodermis, outermost layer in root, composed of closely packed parenchymatous cells, and usually epidermis is single layered with thin walled cells. Cuticle is absent, and cuticle present in some aerial roots, root hairs present in epidermal cells. Okay, in the picture, root hairs are depicted on the epidermal cells. Root hairs, unicellular, unbranched, thin walled epidermal extensions. On orchids, the epidermis is multilayered and transformed into specialized water-absorbing velament tissues. Cells of the velaments are dead with band-like thickenings. Velament tissues. What are velament tissues? Absorb moisture from the atmosphere, prevent water loss from cortex, and provide mechanical support. Function of epidermis. Act as the outermost boundary. It provides the protection. Root hairs help to absorb water and nutrients from the soil. And velament tissue in orchids help to absorb water from the atmosphere. Clear? Move towards the second part, that is cortex. Ground tissue occupies between epidermis and vascular tissue. Is well developed in monocot roots, composed of loosely packed parenchymatous cells. Thick walled hypodermis present in zemes, corn. In some plants, cortex is very large and differentiated into three zones: outer, middle, and inner cortex. Outer cortex is composed of small thin walled cells. Middle cortex is composed of large cells, serve as storage space, and inner cortex composed of few large and thin walled cells. In aquatic plants such as Potamogeton, cortex is transversed by large air spaces or lacunae. Clear? Such cortex is called as lacunate cortex, the cortex that possess lacunae. Functions of cortex: can do photosynthesis in aerial parts or aerial roots. Parenchyma allow gaseous exchange. Parenchyma provides buoyancy in aquatic plants. Store starch and agastic substances. Hold resins, canals, and ducts. Second part was cortex, and now we are moving towards the third part, that is epidermis, endodermis. Epi means upon and endo means inside. Innermost layer of the cortex, prominent and conspicuous in roots. Cells are large and are barrel shaped, possess special thickening in the radial and inner tangential walls. Such thickening is called Casparian thickening or Casparian bands. Clear? Endodermis cells, opposite to protoxylem, remain thin walled. These cells lack the Casparian thickenings. These thin walled endodermal cells are called passage cells. Passage cells allow transport of water from cortex to xylem. Endodermal cells store starch grains, known as starch sheath. Functions of endodermis. The exact function of endodermis is still not clear. Casparian thickening does not allow free passage of water from cortex to steel. Endodermal cells can store food materials as starch grains. Fourth part is pericycle. Pericycle layers of cells are between endodermis and vascular tissues. Usually, pericycle is single-layered parenchymatous cell. In Smilax, pericycle is multistriate and thick-walled. Function of pericycle is lateral roots originate from pericycle. Move towards the fifth part, that is vascular tissue. Radial vascular tissues are present. Radial means alternating strands of xylem and phloem. Alternate with each other, alternate with each other, okay. Xylem strand number varies from 6 to many. That means hexarch to polyarch. Xylem is exarch. Outside, metaxylem elements are circular in outline. Phloem composed of sieve tubes, companion cells, and phloem parenchyma. Protophloem elements occupy towards the periphery. Metaphloem elements towards the inner side. Clear? Move towards the fifth part, vascular tissue. Continue. Functions of vascular tissue are conduction of water in case of xylem and conduction of food in case of phloem, and also they provide the mechanical support. Sixth part is conjunctive tissues. Conjunctive tissues are the cells that occupy between xylem and phloem, conjugate the xylem and phloem. Composed of closely packed parenchymatous cells in mature root, it may become sclerenchymatous. Do not have meristematic activities, that is, there is no secondary growth. Functions of conjunctive tissues are to provide mechanical support or store starch grains. Clear? Seventh most part is pith. Exact center portion of the root is known as pith. Large pith at the center, that is the characteristics of monocot root. Composed of loosely packed parenchymatous cells, pith becomes sclerenchymatous in mature roots. Air chambers are present in the pith of aquatic plants, and function of pith is that the cell stores starch grains. Resin canals and ducts are present in cortex. Practical identification points that monocot root you can analyze or identify: single layer of epidermis without cuticle, presence of unicellular unbranded epidermal hairs, okay. Cortex is undifferentiated, chlorenchymatous zone absent in the cortex, very distinct endodermis and pericycle, radial arrangements of vascular bundles, exarch xylem, prominent Casparian thickening and distinct passage cells. Clear? More than six vascular strands are obvious. Vascular vessel elements of xylem are circular in outline in cross-section. Presence of large pith in the center. Here a complete anatomical diagram of Colocasia monocot root is depicted in your screen. A review question that might be asked about the monocot root. With a neat cellular diagram, explain the anatomy of monocot root. What is Casparian thickening? What are the functions of endodermis in roots? How anatomical features of monocot root is different from monocot stem? Describe the structure of vascular tissues in monocot roots. What are the functions of cortex in monocot roots? What is velamen tissue? Explain its function. What are the differences between dicot root and monocot root? Hope you enjoyed the video. Stay motivated. God bless you. Allah Hafiz.